Hello everybody, it's Michelle Buchanan here with your numerology forecast for September 2021. So let's begin by calculating your personal year number for the whole year. We do this by adding the day and month of your birth date to number 5. Why number 5? Because 2021 adds up to 5. So one more time, we're going to add the day and month of your birth date to number 5. Let me use the birth date example of 28th of March. We would go 2 plus 8 plus 3 plus 5. In this example, our next rule of thumb is to continue adding together any double digit numbers until you eventually get a single number between 1 and 9. And that single number is your personal year number for the whole year. So once again, our example of the 28th of March, adding that to number 5, 2 plus 8 plus 3 plus 5 equals 18. Continue adding any double digits together until you get a single number between 1 and 9. And in this case, 18, we add the 1 plus 8 equals single digit 9. Okay, last time, add the day and month of your birth date to number 5. Keep adding any double numbers together until you get a single digit number between 1 and 9, and that is your personal year number for the whole year. Okay, let me start with personal year number 1. So you guys are in a... Now here's the thing I need to tell everybody first of all, is whenever we hit September, we always get a double amplified energy of our personal year number, because the personal month and the personal year number in September every year for everybody is the same. All right, so that means you are in a one personal year, but also a one personal month for the whole of September. So that means whatever one represents, we're amplifying it. It's more obvious this month. And so therefore, the one is all about new beginnings, okay? New opportunities. It's about a fresh start, creating something new. Now, some people, everybody's lives are different and everybody's circumstances are different and everybody's journey is different, right? So some people are gonna have really obvious new opportunities and new experiences in their lives. Some people's new experiences or new opportunities are quite big and quite obvious. For example, some people may have something big happen, something that's new. For example, a new relationship, a new job, moving into a new home, a new circle of friends. You know, other people may not have anything that major happen, so they might still be in the same job, the same relationship, the same home. Nothing major or significant is created in their life or begins, but it can be something a bit smaller, and even to the point where it can even be something really subtle, because it's not really the size of the new opportunity or experience that matters here. It's basically life is trying to encourage us, if we're in a one cycle, to be open to what we need to embrace in our life that is new. So for example, it might be a new way of doing something that you always do a certain way that is not really going to be of any benefit to you in your life, okay? So examples of subtle one energies and things that can happen in some people's lives that are in the one cycle can mean having a new idea for a new project, for example, or a new way of perceiving an existing situation or an existing problem. For example, if you take on this new perception, let's say you've had an issue with a family member or something you've gone through that was very unpleasant in your life, and you've always perceived it from a certain perspective that does nothing but cause you anger and misery and doesn't feel very good. But in this one cycle, you're being encouraged to maybe open your mind to other ways of perceiving that same experience from a higher perspective, for example. And somebody in a one cycle might do that and look at it from a different point of view, and therefore it can change their entire life. It can improve their health. It can improve the actual circumstances in their life around them, because they've shifted their focus into a more higher place. So therefore emotions, there's not that heavy, dense energy attached to the issue anymore. As you enhance and change and have a new perception, you raise the energy around it, and therefore the sequence of events can start to really change and happen in your life. Better things can start coming because just that minor new way of looking at something or a new way of perceiving something. Okay, and so it's not about how big or small these new things are in our life in a one cycle. It's just the fact that we notice them when we take those steps as to what where the real gem lies and how to make the most of a specific cycle of time. Other things to look at are new tools you might take on board to help you get from A to Z in your life. It might be like I said, a new thing to do at work, like a new project, new clients, a new way of doing your job that you've not taken on before. Again, a new way of looking at situations, a new way of perceiving life. It can even be, and here's a really big one, but very simple, but very, very significant in our life, a new appreciation of even just the small things. You know, it's not till the shit hits the fan and things start getting a bit harder in life that we really look back and go, man, I was so lucky before this challenge came on my path. Take lockdown, for example, or COVID and how that's changed the world. Boy, I was so lucky before. I didn't even realize how lucky I was before. You know, I really appreciate other people around me now. I really appreciate, you know, my family more. I really appreciate how lucky I was to even be able to go get out and get out of my bed and go, leave my home in the morning and go to work. And all I did was complain when I was there, but now I'd give anything to be able to leave the house and go to work and earn money. You know, like this, it's just a new way of looking at things, a new way of thinking, being, living, because in that shift, especially if it's in a positive direction, you can change your entire life. You can improve your entire well-being and health, and it's got so many more benefits than simply just having an optimistic mindset. There's a lot more going on behind the scenes. So make the most of your 1 month and your entire 1 year that you are in for everybody in the one cycle. I will leave that with you, and I will move on now to personal year number two. You guys are in a amplified month of two because you're in a 2 year for the whole year. But in September, we get a double dose of our personal year number because September is, you know, is the same number as the year. So what I mean by that is you're in a 2 year, but for the month of September, you're in a 2 month. How do I get that? Because September, we add nine. We add the month of September, which is a number nine, to the year that you're in. 9 plus 2 is 11, which breaks down to a two. So because it's an 11-2, the fact is all number 2 energy, regardless of whether it's a straight 2, a 29-2, an 11-2, it really doesn't matter. Just 2 in itself is asking you and leading you in a direction that's saying, recognize and understand your emotional side of yourself. Let emotions come to the surface. Whenever we express emotion, it's so healthy for us. It's almost like, it's an awful example to use, but it sort of gets the point across. Let's say you've got a pimple and it comes to a head and finally you squeeze it out or it pops and all that yuckiness gets out. It's kind of like the same as when you express yourself emotionally, when you're crying, when you're upset, when you release that energy, it needs to come out. And a lot of the time when we're expressing emotion, especially, you know, painful emotions or sadness, crying, it's not only the emotion that we're feeling is not only from that isolated experience that you may be crying about at the time. It's a buildup of all that emotion that's been stored in every cell of your being. I don't want to get too woo-woo, but even beyond this lifetime. But let's just use this lifetime in the example, just to be a bit more practical here. But, you know, you've accumulated every pain, every rejection, every heartache, every insecurity, every fear. The emotions of that have been stored in every cell of your being since the moment you were even in the womb, since you've been born in this lifetime, and it's stored in you. And so when you cry or you have a release, it's like the faucet's on, and we want to release those stored emotions and feelings and thoughts. And so the 2 year is giving you plenty of opportunity to be able to do that. So the first thing, those that are in the two that you need to know is, number one, don't feel this is the new you. That you're going to be overly emotional or extra sensitive forever. It's just the cycle that you're in. So you're not going to stay this way. You're not going crazy. But it is an opportunity for you to release, to understand, to acknowledge any emotions, any experiences that you've you've had in your past and in your present life, so that you can have a clean slate and sort of be able to be a lot more in balance, because number two is also the number of balance. And it's almost like, in order for you to function to the best of your capability, we need you in a strong equilibrium. We need you grounded, centered, balanced, stable, secure. And the 2 year is giving you a chance to do the work behind the scenes to get yourself in balance. Some people, it's emotional balance and being able to sort of hold themselves emotionally and control their emotions, not control them, but sort of work with them, understand your own behaviors and your own emotional patterns. Other people, it can be balanced, simple things like balance, but simply logical, practical things in your everyday life, like the balance between giving and receiving, finding balance between, you know, intuition and logic, balance between self-confidence, and balance takes shape. But it's about you learning to love yourself, to know yourself, to understand yourself, and to embrace every part of yourself so that you can be a well-rounded, strong, confident human being. So this is a month and a year for you to do the work behind the scenes that enables you to be that balanced, stable, secure, self-aware human being, so that you can go forward and live your best life from that moment on. Great number to get close and have those meaningful conversations with people, those meaningful one-on-one moments. And on the, in the challenging side of it, it can be a time where you can have life experiences come that cause you, that trigger emotions. And there's nothing wrong with that, because it's a healthy thing. But it is an opportunity for you to sort of work through some of those emotional sides of yourself. Great number for people to get closer. One-on-one relationships, that kind of thing. At the very least, it's a great number that is encouraging you to be more cooperative, to be more of a mediator, to be more understanding of other people, to be more compassionate, and also more understanding and kinder to your own self also. So I'll leave that with you, and I'll move on now to personal year number three. You guys are in a double three month for September. And what that means, that double three, is it means you're in a 3 year for the whole year, but for the month of September, you're also in a three personal month. So it's a double three energy, and the three for this whole year, and especially it's going to be amplified this month, is a three is asking you to get really clear about your own joy and happiness, and working out what makes you, first of all, what makes you unhappy, what is holding you back from feeling joyful, happy, content, satisfied in this life. Because what can sometimes happen with the three energy is it can highlight that. It does also work on emotions, but especially it's trying to get us to pay attention to what is preventing us from being happy, because three is the number of joy. It is the number of happiness. It is a number of playfulness. It is a number of self-expression. It is the number of, you know, optimism. And so if we're in a three cycle, it's where we're being encouraged to look at why we don't feel happy. So first and foremost, take a look at yourself and your patterns of behavior and your programmed, patterns that you have and triggers that you have, or even the way you perceive yourself, others in the world in a negative way. What are those perceptions? Where do they come from? What do you really think? What do you really feel? What is preventing you from feeling safe, happy, secure? And take a look at those things so that you can, maybe you might want to write them down. Look at where those thoughts and beliefs stem from. Take a look at the illusion in them. Why we have no evidence that things can get better, because no one can really see the future and what's coming. And it is challenging times on the planet, especially at this present time. Is where there's no harm in choosing to see the glass half full rather than half empty, because it sure feels like shit to feel down, to feel pessimistic, to feel negative, to have no hope. Even though what we see around us gives us good reason to feel that way, even though life is extremely challenging at times, and it's very difficult, you can still go through a challenge with that belief and that mindset that says, this won't last forever. I can get through this. There are still good things in life. There are still good people in the world somewhere. There is still good in the world. There are still things to celebrate. There is still happiness. There's art, there's creativity, there's music, there's humor. There's so much in the world to be happy about. And it's about really getting to know what's important and what's not. Maybe moving away from some of those false illusions of what we think make us happy, whether it's material goals or success or money or popularity or whatever it might be. And really getting down to the nitty gritty and the basics of what really is important in life and where true soul happiness comes from. And so, you know, it's about being aware of what makes you feel good. You know, it doesn't have to be anything rocket science. It's actually very simple things. It can be having a one-on-one conversation with someone that where you're clearing the air. It can be playing music that you love or reading a book or cooking, making recipes that you love to cook and create. It can be being in the garden. It can be playing with the dog. You know, everyone's different. But this 3-month and year is really giving you an opportunity to really do more of what makes you feel good, because you are the one in charge of your happiness and your joy. And that comes from how you perceive your everyday experiences, how you perceive yourself, how you perceive others, how you perceive the world, and how you choose to view your life so far. Are you in a space of blame? Are you in a space of anger, unforgiveness, fear? You know, this 3 year and month is asking you to choose to see a light at the end of the tunnel, even though you have no evidence that there's a light in there at the end of the tunnel in the first place. To dare to believe there is. To dare to believe that in the good in the world, to dare to be happy. And go out of your way to express yourself. So the 3 is also the number of self-expression. It's the number of communication. It's the number of socializing. It's the number of speaking your truth. And it's the number of artistic expression. So I'll leave that with you, and I wish you a fabulous month and remainder of the year. Moving on now to personal year number 4. You guys are in a double 4 energy for the month of September. So that means you're in a 4 personal year and a 4 personal month. And the number 4, as you probably have heard me say in previous forecasts throughout the year, the 4 is a stabilizing month where it can sometimes break old rusty foundations that are not going to stand the test of time. It will pull them out of your life. It will break them down so that you can rebuild upon a more stable, solid foundation. So this whole year is about doing whatever needs to be done to get your life and your own personal self and your own personal mindset, your own personal well-being and your physical world where you need it or want it to be so that you are on a more stable foundation. So what does that involve? Everyone's life is different. Everybody's needs are different. Everybody has different things to learn in this life. Everybody's got a different way of viewing things. And the 4 is saying, let's get back to basics. And the basics are the foundation of your well-being. Let's take a look at building the foundation of your mental well-being, your emotional well-being, your health and your physical well-being. Let's take a look at building. Then let's take a look at the foundations and the structures in your physical world, your finances, your work, your home, your relationships, you know, all that sort of thing. And it's about doing the work that needs to be done to create that stability. So it's kind of going to force you into a situation like that. And for those that are proactive, for those that are prepared to do the work, for those that understand, hey, it might be 1 step forward, 2 steps back, that's okay. I'm just going to take it each moment or each day at a time and just build and chip away slowly. Slow and steady wins the race. It's okay. I can handle whatever comes my way. I know that life was not always meant to be easy. I know that life is up and down. I know that. And I can get through the downs, you know, and it's about really building fortitude. It's about taking action, but having the mindset of perseverance, persistence, being a warrior, and that you are not going to accept defeat and crumble. You are going to put your big girl pants on or your big boy pants on, and you're going to do the work. You know, life wasn't always meant to be handed to us on a silver platter. There's shit to be done. There's issues to work on. There's challenges to overcome. And you're not going to lose yourself in that process. That's what 4 is, toughening you up, right? Now, be aware it's a slow-moving energy. So you really do need to be patient. And you can't force things to happen. You have to be 1 step at a time. You have to be prepared for the long haul in terms of, you know, sometimes you're not going to get an instantaneous result. Sometimes things aren't just going to be the way you want them at the first try or first attempt. You might have to go back and try a few times until you get the results that you want. But it's a consistent, persistent effort over a gradual period of time. It's a step-by-step process to get to the end result. So be patient, be tolerant. There may be frustrations where things, you know, don't kind of turn out. There might be delays and obstacles to overcome, but it's about you being able to see the light at the end of the tunnel, even when there's no evidence that the light exists at all. It's about being optimistic, being persevering and persistent, and having fortitude and doing the work to build that solid foundation moving forward. All right, so I wish you the very, very best and for this month and the rest of the year. And I'll move on now to personal year number 5. And you guys, you know, this people in a 5 year, you guys getting a really big dose of 5 energy this month of September, because your year, your personal year number is always going to be the same as the world's year number, or what is also known as the universal year number. Now, it's interesting because for September, we're in a 5 universal year and a 5 universal month. But you also are in a 5 personal year and a 5 personal month for September, combined with the 5 universal year and the 5 universal month. So that's a lot of 5 energy. So what does that 5 mean? So whenever number 5 is related to a cycle of time, not a person, but a cycle of time, the description for that 5 is where life will encourage you to go ahead and make any changes that you know need to be made in your life. Now, that can be on many, many, many levels. Some people, it can be, oh, I've got an unhealthy habit like smoking, or I drink too much, or I'm overeating. I really need to work on that. Other people, it might be, I've got a psychological issue I need to work on. I've got this, you know, negative attitude. I'm so afraid of COVID, or I'm so afraid of my partner cheating on me, or I'm worried that I'm never going to have enough money, and I really want to have lots of nice things, and I'm afraid I'm not going to have them, or I'm scared of being sick, or whatever. Some people, it's a negative or a pessimistic mindset that needs to change. Other people, it can be things like, you know, they're in a situation that isn't healthy for them. It might be they're in a relationship that isn't for their greater, you know, isn't very healthy for them. It can be destructive or negative. Other people, it might be, you know, working in a working environment that they know is really harmful to them. It's making them unwell because they don't want to go to work, but they stay for the money. You know, there's all millions and millions of possibilities of where a change is needed in our life. And some people, and so the 5 is asking you to really think about these sorts of things and to really be courageous enough to make the moves that need to be made for the changes that need to be made in your life. Okay, some people are in a situation where they know there's change that needs to be made, but they're too lazy. All right, so that's kind of not your ideal, because if there's a change that needs to be made and you're just not doing it because you just want the easy road and you don't want to put the effort in, and you know that you need to, but you don't. Sometimes when that can be a little bit skating on thin ice, because sometimes what can happen in life, and I'm not saying it will for you, I'm just saying sometimes it can happen that if there are experiences or actions that we need to take and be responsible and to look out for ourselves and to help ourselves, but we don't. Sometimes life will force that change upon us, where change will be made, but we've got no choice because it's happened to us, rather than us being proactive and being in charge of that change. So for those that know there are changes that need to be made but are just not doing it, just be aware. Carry on as you do, that's fine, but just know that there is a possibility that that change might happen further down the road beyond your control. And you kind of don't want to be in damage control. You want to be a bit more proactive when you manifest, you know, when you're going through changes that are manifesting in your life. Other people, there are changes that need to be made. They don't even understand that they need to be made yet. They don't even know what's around the corner. And that's where things can come from left field. Some things are more global changes that we have no control over. And that's why it's really important in a 5 cycle. And this is the case for every single person on the planet, because this is a 5 universal year this year for all of us, is You really need to be adaptable and flexible and go with the flow, because who knows what's around the corner, and it is a wacky time right now, and it's a matter of really being able to go with the flow and adjust yourself accordingly and try and be as optimistic as you can. Take it one moment at a time. Take it one day at a time. Don't think too far ahead and don't go back to the past. It's a matter of going with the flow of change and not And being able to release the past, especially if the past was better than your present. And that's a really important thing. If the past was better than the present circumstances that you find yourself in, you have to be brave enough to let that go and try your hardest not to compare the two. Because even though you might be in a challenging situation now, change will come again and put you in a better circumstance. In the time, in the days, weeks, months, time that's coming in the future. But it can't if you're stuck in the anger or the frustration or the despair of the past. And this is why it's really important that you are optimistic, that you go with the flow, that you can adjust yourself accordingly, whatever life throws at you, with the right mindset. Let go of the past. Know that you can work through the challenges that you've faced in the present, and then be open to the positivity and the opportunities that are coming, that are to come, you know? And so it's, again, some people need have big changes, and big changes will throw themselves at you. Other people, small, minor things. But one thing's for certain, things are not supposed to stay stagnant. You know, the world is changing. We're going through a big, big planetary change. And this is, you know, there are going to be some adjustments that need to be made along the way, but it can be a really dynamic time as well. You know, to go, we have to go one step forward, two steps back sometimes. But this number five, that year that you're in, it's one of my favorite years, to be honest with you. For me personally, I love the dynamic energy of it. I love that it's got a real magical aspect to it, where anything can happen, and it usually does. Dare to dream, dare to believe that if anything can happen, and it usually does, that it could be something amazing It could be something amazing. You know, dare to believe in the magical side of life. It's a very charismatic vibration. It's a very fast moving. So, you know, you want to, again, not have your finger in too many pies, not be too distracted. It can be harder to finish things. It can be harder to focus, because it's a very, what I call, scattered energy. And there's all sorts of things happening all over the show. And so you need to work harder on your stability. You need to work harder at remaining grounded. And you need to work harder in maintaining your balance and your own personal equilibrium. So, you know, do things, take on some practices that help to center you. So, for example, breathing techniques, working on breath work and proper ways of breathing to stay calm if you're ever in an anxious situation. Meditation, times in nature, exercise, mindfulness thinking, you know, looking at the bigger picture. One of the best things that has created stability and order in my own life is having that higher awareness of my own personal self-awareness of how I behave and why, and my triggers and my programming, but also a higher awareness of the universe itself and life itself. And that bigger picture understanding, which is we are an energetic being having a human experience. You know, we came here to learn and grow. Growing isn't easy. Learning isn't always easy, because sometimes we often learn and grow in hard times. So life was not meant to be a walk in the park. There are going to be challenges, and that's just human nature. It's not that personal. You know, having a deeper understanding and a broader understanding of life, of your spiritual self, of your own personal self, your psychology, and all that sort of thing. But definitely a year, a month to put extra effort into adopting some practices that can help you to stabilize yourself no matter what changes are going on around you, and be really optimistic, because those changes can be really positive too. I wish you the very best in your five cycle, and I'll move on now to personal year number six. And you guys are in a double six energy for the month of September, because you've got a six personal year and a six personal month in September. So that's doubling the influence that number six will have upon your life this month. So what is that influence? Well, number six is a number that encourages us to look at the relationships in our life. And those relationships aren't just with a love, you know, a partner, soulmate, love of our life, or whoever we're matched up with relationship. It's all the relationships in our life. So it's our relationships with our family members, our relationships with neighbors, our relationships with friends, our relationships with children, our relationships with work colleagues, our relationships with clients, our relationships with other people in the community, you know, our relationship to our country, all those kinds of things. And it's not just the relationship in the here and now, it's the history of the relationships, because they affect us on a personal level, and it's our history. And our interactions and the relationships that we've had with others often create who we are today. And the whole purpose of our life is to evolve from our lower self to our higher self. And a lot of that comes from self-awareness and examining the role that we play in the relationships we have with others really helps us to understand ourselves better. So other people give us an opportunity to mirror back to us who we are, how we see the world. And if we've got things we need to work on, then it's going to be obvious in the other people that we interact with. And so this year and this month in particular, asking you to look at your history, to look at your present, to look at all the interactions you have with people and what is it mirroring back to you that you know needs to be improved, or that is causing issues or circumstances for you that you know need to be improved so that you can feel happier in yourself and live a happier, more fulfilled, balanced, harmonious life. It's looking at the good that you do in your relationships, the positives of the relationships and how they've formed you and how you are behaving and doing more of what is good and doing more for other people and being less self-centered and being more compassionate, more understanding, more giving, more caring. Number six is the number of service. It's a number of being able to do more for other people and less for yourself. And that's family, that's community, that's, you know, neighbors, colleagues at work, all kinds of things. And it's about being a shoulder to cry on when you need to. The six also relates to home and the family and the home. So it's actually your actual physical dwelling where you reside. So are there improvements that need to be made in the space that you're living in to make you feel a bit better? Would you benefit from maybe having a clean up or a tidy up? The number six is getting out in the garden, you know. It's not just about the home. It can also be about your own personal self-love. So working on your relationship with yourself and building your self-confidence, understanding yourself better, making friends with yourself, making peace with yourself, forgiving the past, all of that kind of thing. It's also a very creative number. So it's a month where in a year where you might be encouraged to express yourself creatively. And that can be just simply for the purpose of being more balanced within yourself. As you express yourself creatively and you release that energy, it can also put you in a nice state of equilibrium. Because especially if you're feeling anxious or stressed, when you express and you're doing something artistically or creatively that makes you feel good, whether it's dance, whether it's music, whether it's sewing, whether it's gardening, cooking, whatever, and you're expressing yourself, it helps to raise your vibration. If you're doing something artistic or creative or expressing yourself in a positive way so that it feels emotionally good to you, it's really beneficial to your health and well-being, and it's really beneficial to helping to improve problems in your life. It's really helping to improve the circumstances of your life, because when your vibration is lifted and you're on a higher frequency by doing things creatively that feel good, that shifts all that heavy energy of where you might be stagnant in the physical world, or where you're normally angry, or you're frustrated, or you're impatient, or you're afraid in your normal mindset. Everything sort of stuck in a heavy, dense energy. But when you then go ahead and you break away from that, you do something artistic or creative that feels good, or anything that feels good. It doesn't have to be something creative. It can be, I feel good when I watch reruns of Friends on Netflix. I feel good when I make a beautiful toasted sandwich and I sit there with a nice cup of tea and eat my toasted sandwich. It doesn't matter what it is that feels good, as long as it's not legal, you know, illegal. But whatever it is that you're doing that feels good, when you make an effort to get into that space, you move out of the heavy, dense energy. And when you're in the space where you're feeling emotionally good, your frequency raises, and then you can start to see the universe. You're magnetic, remember? So when you're feeling better, the universe starts to send you better opportunities. better experiences, better solutions to issues. Things start to happen, things start to move in a more positive direction, but you have to start that process off yourself. Start that process off yourself by taking the steps consciously to make an effort to get yourself into that space, all right? So I'll leave that with you and I wish you the very best, and I'll move on now to personal year number 7. So you guys are in a double 7 energy this month because you're in a 7 personal year, but you're also in a 7 personal month. So we've got a double dose of that 7 for you this month. Now, what does that mean? Well, if you've been listening to my forecasts this entire year, you will hear me say that 7 is the number of going within. So while life is still existing in the outer world, like you've still got things to do, you've got people around you, you've got family, people, you've got maybe a lot of you have work commitments and life goes on the outside. So that's still obviously happening, but it's the 7 year is asking you to really get deeper on the inside. And what I mean by that is really, first and foremost, really get to know yourself better. Look at yourself, self-examination, self-contemplation. Who am I? Why? What do I think? What do I feel about myself, about life, about the world, about other people? Why do I think that? Why do I feel that? Why do I perceive it like that? Is that a positive way of looking at it? Is this helping me in life? Is this doing me any good? Or does it make me feel like shit? Oh, I feel like shit. Oh, I'm angry all the time. I'm stressed out. I'm afraid. I'm worried. I'm bitter about that thing that happened, or I've got an issue with that person. I don't really want to be that. I don't want to feel that way. I don't want to be that way. Why do I think that? Why do I feel that? Let's go back and have a look at those perceptions from a different angle. Hey, maybe if I look at it from this other angle and perceive it from a higher perspective, I won't feel like shit so much. I won't be so angry. Oh, I can forgive them now. I can let that go. I can move on. I can be free. Oh, wow, I start to feel better. Better things are happening to me. Oh my goodness, the world is opening up. Opportunities are out there for me. It's really just everything begins from the inside. And the 7 year is saying, sure, go out there, be a physical person, live your life, be in the physical world. But you've got to know that everything stems from within. Know yourself spiritually. Know that you are a soul, that you are an energy, an energetic spiritual being having a human experience. And the higher your perspective, the broader your understanding of yourself, the universe, and the secrets and mysteries of the universe, that you, information that you cannot see with the physical eye, ancient wisdom that is actually very simple. Everything is energy. Thoughts are energy. We're all connected. We're all one big mass working on things together, trying to get as individuals to from our lower to our higher selves to evolve, to grow, and learn from the experiences that we have while we're here. And our thoughts are magnetic, and our emotions are magnetic, and we attract to us what we think and believe, what we're generating out, what we're projecting out. We're magnetically attracting back to us based on our thoughts and beliefs, based on our psychology, based on what we think and feel from, especially from the age of birth to 7. But the 7 year is asking you to think this way. It's asking you for some quiet time alone, because it's only in the quiet time away from distractions and busyness that the aha moments can really filter through. That when we're contemplating and thinking, even if we're going for a walk on our own without music, without headphones, without someone else that we're yapping to, and we're on our own and we've got opportunities for the information to just appear in our mind. The answers to the big questions, the solutions to problems, the new perceptions that are required to get us to that higher state of understanding. You know, it's only in that quiet time alone, in that space that's away from the hustle and bustle, that the penny can drop. When that penny drops, it can change your entire life. It can be a slightly different way of perceiving a situation that you've always perceived was one certain way, and it's messed you up because you feel like that shouldn't have happened and it's not fair. And then you look at it from another perspective and then you're like, oh my God. And then everything just recalibrates in your life. And you the heaviness is gone and you're in that lighter frequency. And boom, what do you know? Doors open, opportunities come, things get better, health improves, blah, blah, blah. The 7 is saying, don't waste this time. Don't spend all your time focusing on the physical and the material, thinking that's the be all and end all and that's the only thing that's going to make you happy. It's what's inside that matters the most. And the seven is encouraging you to get closer to whatever you believe spiritually. So it's asking you to connect with some sort of spiritual practice or spiritual awareness. It's asking you to focus on your personal development, your self-awareness. It's asking you for some quiet time alone for rest, relaxation, contemplation, health, and well-being. And it's a great vibration also, or a great period of time to study and to learn, to specialize in something, to focus on something and put your energy into something. So again, you might not want to feel as social as you normally would this year, and there's a reason for that. But you know, the more work you do internally this year, the greater your rewards will be in the physical world as a result. So that's why, another reason why it's so important. So I'll leave that with you, and I'll move on now to personal year number 8. You guys are in a double amplified, double dose energy of 8 this month. You're in an 8 year all year, but you're also in an 8 personal month this month. And what does that number 8 mean? Well, for those of you that have been listening all year, you'll know that I've been saying 8 is the number of your personal power. It's about your relationship with your life force energy. And so the 8 is that life force that runs through the essence of all you are. It's that life force energy that runs through every cell of your being, and it is connected to your thoughts, your emotions, and how you project your energy out into the world. And the 8 is saying, let's tidy that up. Let's get you in a strong, centered, balanced foundation. Because that, if you look at a number 8, it's like two circles balancing on top of each other. And it also means as above, so below. It means finding balance between, finding a nice equilibrium, a nice balance between material and the spiritual worlds, and between self-confidence and lack of self-esteem. Between giving and receiving, between optimism and pessimism. It's about finding balance in your everyday life based on your thoughts and emotions that you are projecting out into the world through your valuable life force energy. And not allowing, or first of all, learning and getting, or making yourself aware of what causes you to feel disempowered. So what disempowers you? Let me give you some examples. Some people are disempowered by other people. It can be an overpowering person or someone that just triggers them, and they've got an issue with someone. And every time they think of that person or have an interaction with that person, they lose, they siphon, they, what does Carolyn May say? She says, forgotten what she says. You lose your valuable life force energy when you're thinking in a negative way. And what you're doing is you're siphoning, you're losing that energy that could otherwise be used to get you in a better place, to attract opportunities to you, to improve your health. And so, you know, you can be disempowered by a person or a situation or a negative thing that when you think about it, boom, you lose your valuable life force energy. We can be disempowered by a fear, a worry, a limiting belief, a destructive pattern of behavior. These things are disempowering to us. Also, we can be disempowered by lack of self-confidence, lack of self-belief. You know, there's all these things, and the 8 is saying, hey, take a look at these things this year, because we don't want you wasting that valuable life force energy on these things. We don't want you being disempowered anymore. We want you to empower yourself, to become self-empowered by overcoming these triggers, by overcoming these disempowering situations that you are in. And as you start to release them, to understand them, to acknowledge them, to embrace them, to accept them, to release them, you then start to become self-empowered. And that valuable life force energy is used for better things. And this year, life is asking you to really, really find out where your leak. That's what Carolyn May says. She says hemorrhaging. I love that word because it's so powerful. You don't want to hemorrhage your valuable life force energy. You want to seal up that energetic aura that you have and keep that beautiful life force energy within yourself and use it to good for good things. Attracting favorable outcomes to solutions to problems, being in the right place at the right time with synchronicity, being in sync and synchronicity with life itself, you know, improving your health, being happier within yourself, you know, all these sorts of things is what we can look forward to when we are maintaining that valuable life force energy. So the eight is asking you to take a look at those things. On more of a physical, practical level, it can also be the number of balancing your finances and money. And money isn't just money, it can be, you know, power, successes, those sorts of things, to get in balance with that, to know that it's okay to want nice things. It's okay to want to attract money. There's nothing wrong with that. It's great. It's just when you want it so badly, you think it's the be all and end all. It's when you're out of balance with that desire for success, money, materialistic things. It's when you're out of balance with that desire, and that when you feel that that's what's going to make you happy, when you give that more importance than, for example, being a good, decent human being, you know, or you give material things more importance than having a deep and meaningful connection with another human being, or being of service or helping. It's like, oh, I don't want to help someone. I'd much rather gather up that materialistic thing for myself. You know, it's about sort of breaking away from that way of thinking and being. It's a great time to work on your finances. It's a great time to look at your career, a great way of looking at new ways that you can become more abundant. It's just knowing that money doesn't define you, to find healthy balance with that abundance and that desire for material satisfaction and wealth and stability. On the other hand, it's also about overcoming a poverty consciousness, because that eighth money side of the eight is not just about, you know, trying to attract more money. It can also be about overcoming a poverty consciousness, a poverty mindset of, oh, I never have enough, or it's not fair, it's I always lose money, or I keep spending, or I never get it, or I always have bad things happen, or whatever, you know. So there's a lot going on with that eight, but it's about you learning to control yourself, to maintain your balance, and to be aware of what disempowers you, and working on that. Also, it's a strong number for the law of attraction and understanding twofold, you know, in terms of that disempowerment, empowerment sort of formula that's going on. It's about you understanding that, hey, you've got a great incentive for overcoming what disempowers you, because you're manifesting based on what you're projecting out. So you are creating and attracting situations, people, circumstances in your life based on what you're projecting out from that life force energy. So there's the incentive. You want to work and overcome what disempowers you, so that you can use that valuable life force energy and the law of attraction to manifest better things in your life, okay? I'll leave that with you, and I'll move on now to personal year number 9. So you guys are in a double 9 energy for the month of September, because you've got a 9 personal year. You're in a 9 personal month for September. So it's out with the ultimate way for the new, guys. We've got a double dose of that. And so, you know, it can be a really exciting time, because when you know that you're so ready, your heart and soul are ready for a new beginning. You're ready to release what you've been carrying around. You're ready to look at what needs to be addressed and start making the necessary changes and improvements. And you're so ready to leave that old you or that old past behind. And it's time to sort of start really feeling good about that. And everyone's life is different. Everybody has different things that they're working on. Everybody's life purpose and life's journey is different. They've all got different things that they're dealing with, different needs, different things that need to be, you know, completed, and different new beginnings to come. So because we're all different, we're all at different stages and got different lives, and some people, everyone's going to experience their 9 energy totally differently. Some people can have really big out with the old to make way for the new endings and completion situations. For example, some might finally end a long period of years of study. Some might end a relationship. Some may be, you know, leave a job. Some people may have really big, obvious things happen in that 9 cycle for the whole year. And next year too, it can happen, because we're in a 1 year and, you know, of new beginnings next year. But sometimes when something begins, something has to end first. So, you know, I think of the 9 and the 1 as a twofold sort of double happy energy, if you like, where they kind of out with the old, make way for the new, kind of double 2 year period. And then you have other people where it's not so dramatic and so obvious with what's out with the old to make way for the new. It can be minor things. You know, like, oh, I used to always, my whole life, believe that I got the short end of the stick in my childhood, and that this thing shouldn't have happened to me, and this went wrong, and how unfair it all was, and how unjust life is. And I carried that round for 40 something years. And then in my 9 year, I saw it from a totally different perspective and saw the benefit of what that helped, what that did for me. And now I view it from a whole different mindset, and my whole life has changed as a result. You can have people thinking that way and saying that. You know, it's definitely, you know, it can be something as simple as a new mindset, or out with the old in terms of a way of perceiving a situation. It can be out with the old in a completion of a bad health habit, you know, like smoking, or, you know, drinking too much or whatever. You know, it can be finally having the courage to, you know, leave the past behind and start a whole new future. You know, it doesn't have to be big things like big jobs and endings of relationships and moving house and big, big things. It can be everything's the same in your life, same house, same job, same relationship, same everything. But you just have this epiphany or this awakening or this new way of seeing things and living, or a new tweaking your diet or your health and well-being, and boom, a whole new doorway opens, a whole new life happens for you because of one minor change. And that's how it works. The size of the change is irrelevant. It's the energy that change creates and how it influences you and your life in the present and the moving forward in the future. And don't you for 1 minute think that something small isn't going to have a big impact in your life, because sometimes it's really interesting. Sometimes it's actually something, sometimes it's only something small that needs to change to have a big shift. You know, we just complicate things by, you know, we overcomplicate things by thinking and dramatize things, making things a lot worse, but they're really actually very simple. So know that it's a great time for you to let go of what no longer serves, or what's holding you back, what is causing you misery. And sometimes you will find that misery is your own mindset, your own way of viewing things. Nine is also a time to be more compassionate and understanding of other people and yourself, but understanding others and being kinder and being forgiving and being giving to the community, you know, being that helping hand, helping out the community, other people that need help, strangers, being more of that sort of mindset, being more community orientated. It's also a time of forgiveness, letting the past be the past and letting it go. It's also about creative expression is really important as well in the nine, especially positive creative expression that makes you feel good, because the more better you feel emotionally, the higher your vibration. The higher your vibration, the more in synchronicity you are with life itself, being in the right place at the right time, the more you improve your physical health, the more life can come to you and offer solutions to problems and opportunities to you. But you have to be in the right frequency for that. How do you get in that right frequency? Through your thoughts and emotions. Your thoughts and emotions need to be in a positive space. How do you get in a positive space? By going out of your way to deliberately make yourself feel better. By thinking better, by doing something, taking an action or doing something physically or mentally or emotionally that makes you feel better. You are in control here. You are the one that decides whether you are going to pick yourself up and choose to see a light at the end of the tunnel, regardless of whether there's actually a light there or not. You are going to see the glass half full, not empty. And just even something as simple as that action can shift your entire life. I'm not even joking. And if you're going to do that, this is the time to do it. Every time is the time to do it, to have that new mindset, but especially this year. So I wish you the very best, and I will leave that with you, and I will have a forecast for you next month in October, on the 1st of October. Take care and God bless.